This is Felix the Handyman. I'm here with a tip for you folks that do woodwork and are tired of buying hole saws. These hole saws, they go dull and the teeth go bad. And they cost a lot of money to replace them time after time again. So what I put together here is a simple hole saw sharpening tool. It's just a simple jig made out of a regular grinder with a metal sharp cutting tip. You unscrew the handle that supports it and you make a hole in a 4x16 plank of wood. You put supports on the bottom, and this hole you run a bolt through here with a nut on the two locations to tighten it. Over here you have small sections of wood. You take a router, cut a groove on the two sides so that way you'll be able to use your cabinet hangers. Now these cabinet hangers only cost 50 cents. You cut a piece of wood, it goes all the way across. And you drill a hole for your quarter inch bolt. This quarter inch bolt is gonna hold your bit so that you can sharpen it. Okay, I'm gonna put this together, show you how it goes, and I can show you how simple it is. You take a piece of all thread, lock the nuts together on the end. You run it through your bit. Of course, you could have adapters for different size holders, but the majority of these are a quarter inch drill bit that run through here, so you could use a quarter inch all thread. You run this through the hole that you have already cut and aligned for your cabinet holders. Washer, spacer, nut. Put the nut on here. Run it down. Snug it up. Continue to do so until you feel the nut start to bottom out. You want to leave that little bit of tension on there. Make sure it is bottomed out. Then you got a little bit of tension on there. Use the wing nut to lock it in place. You adjust the tension to whatever tension you prefer. If you want a lot, you put a lot. If you want a little bit, you put a little bit. But the main thing for adjusting the tension and locking it is so that you have a guide. As you're sharpening the tool, your cabinet holders will guide your bit, and you'll have turn your grinder on, you have your bit on there, you bring it in, you make a mark so you can know where you start at. Okay, let me change over and show you where how it's done. Now what you're going to do is you're going to put your bit up against there, and you're going to check your angle of your teeth. Once you got that set up, then you're going to turn on your motor and you're going to run it in there one at a time. I see people turn their heads and quickly look away. Like a newborn baby. In your starting area is so that you'll know when to stop, because this little thing does it so quickly and efficiently that you don't know when you're all the way done. That way you have that marked indication. Now that you're done, You merely unloosen your wing nut. It's not easy facing up when your whole world is black. No more will my grief. Loosen your nut. Turn a deeper blue. I could not force it. This is happening to you. If I look out, light out your guys. My love would love with me before the morning comes. And you got a brand new sharpened hole saw. And it didn't cost you not a penny. You did it yourself with this simple guy. And all this guy is, remember, a couple of drawer hangers on the wood. Those rules are done with the router. Okay, on a lot of hole saws, some of them have permanent attachments on there. Some of them have oversized holes. It's easy to adapt these. Main thing to remember is your quarter inch all thread. I wanna see run it through there, tighten it down, black, and rock and roll. Night, once again, hope, Felix the Handyman. Have a nice day.
Ander, riba. Ander, riba.